Hello, students. Lightning is the most spectacular element of a thunderstorm. In many cultures, lightning has been viewed as a part of a deity. In old Finnish folk religion, the god of thunder was named Ukko. Ukko had a magical hammer called Ukonvasara by which he struck lightning. The 18th century scientists started experimenting on lightning. The fundamental nature of electricity was not yet understood, but static electricity was a phenomenon people had observed and described. Benjamin Franklin started to think that lightning and frictional electricity were probably somehow identical. You have probably heard of his famous, wildly dangerous, kite experiment that proved the electric nature of lightning. Electrical phenomena are widespread in the natural world and, unlike thunderstorms, often occur unnoticed in our daily lives. We depend on electricity to do many things that are often taken for granted. There are four basic electrical terms which must be understood: charge, voltage, current, and resistance. You know that everything is made up of atoms, and that atoms consist of a nucleus made up of positively charged protons and chargeless neutrons, and that this nucleus is orbited by negatively charged electrons. This means that every object has positive and negative charges that are normally in balance. However, friction can shift this balance of charges, and this is how the friction causes static electricity. Staattista sähköä. Rubbing the balloon against hair causes electrons to move from the hair to the balloon. This gaining of electrons gives the balloon an overall negative charge, while the hair, with its loss of negative charges, now has a net positive charge. Your positively charged hair is attracted to the negatively charged balloon and starts to rise up to meet it. Charge, varaus, is a physical quantity that has the property of experiencing force when placed in an electromagnetic field. An electromagnetic field is composed of an electric field and magnetic field, which are coupled together. There are two types of charges, the positive and negative. Equal charges repel each other, unequal charges attract each other. The SI-derived unit of electric charge is the coulomb, named after French physicist Charles-Augustin de Coulomb. The charge can be transferred from one body to another body, but no charge is being created or destroyed. Voltage, jännite, is electric potential energy per unit charge, measured in volts. 1 volt is the potential difference between two points that will impart 1 joule of energy per coulomb of charge that passes through it. A large potential difference corresponds to a strong tendency for electron to flow. The volt was named in honor of Italian physicist Alessandro Volta. He invented the electric cell, that is a device that is capable of changing chemical energy into electricity. An electric battery consists of one or more electric cells. The battery is a source of voltage. The voltage the battery supplies should be thought of as a kind of electrical pressure. The battery has positive and negative terminals. A current flows when a battery's terminals are connected to the light bulb by conductors where charges are free to move. Just as water flows downhill in response to a difference in gravitational potential energy, electrons flow through a conductor in response to an electrical potential difference. Electrons flowing through a wire or ions flowing through a solution, both constitute electric current. charge flows in a conductor from one place to other, then the rate of flow of charge is called electric current, sähkövirta. The SI unit of measurement of electric current is the ampere. 1 ampere of current represents 1 coulomb of electrical charge moving past a specific point in 1 second. The ampere is named after André Marie Ampère, who founded the science of electromagnetism. An electrical circuit, virtapiiri, is a path for transmitting electric current. In order for a lamp to light up, the circuit must be closed. In other words, there must be a connection between the poles of a voltage source, for example battery, and the light bulb. In this case, this connection is severed by a switch, so current no longer flows and the bulb no longer lights. In this case, it is called an open circuit, avoin virtapiiri. Electrochemistry refers to the process of converting stored chemical energy into electricity. It involves the exchange of ions. An ion is an atom with a net electrical charge. An electrolyte is a medium containing ions. This includes most salts, acids, and bases dissolved in water. The most common everyday example of electrochemistry in action is the battery, baristo. In batteries, 2 different materials are used as electrodes, anode and cathode. Combining the electron-losing tendency of one substance with the electron-gaining tendency of another creates electric current. The external wire provides the pathway for the flow of negatively charged electrons from one electrode to the other, outside of the battery. While the circuit is closed by the electrolyte's ions. The electrolyte provides the pathway for the transfer of positively charged ions to balance the negative flow. In most cases, laptop batteries are lithium-ion batteries. In the lithium-ion battery, the spontaneous flow of lithium ions from the graphite anode to the lithium cobalt oxide cathode causes a corresponding flow of electrons in the external circuit. Upon recharging, cobalt is oxidized, forcing the lithium to migrate back to the graphite. All batteries, including the lithium-ion batteries, operate with direct current, DC, tasavirta. In direct current, electrons flow steadily in one direction. With a direct current, current always flows from positive to negative. An electric current is actually caused by a flow of electrons moving from a negatively charged end to a positively charged end. This movement of electrons towards the positively charged end is known as electron flow. Conventional current flow exists for historical reasons. Electricity was discovered before electrons were discovered, and it was known which way they move in a circuit. Alternating current, AC, vaihtovirta, is a type of current that changes its direction of flow over time. This happens periodically. Most of the electrical energy produced is alternating current, therefore AC systems are used for many applications. An alternating current generator takes mechanical motion and converts it into electricity. The mechanical energy may come from a number of sources. Hydraulic turbines at dams or waterfalls, wind turbines, steam turbines using steam produced with heat from the combustion of fuels or from nuclear fission, and so on. The mechanical energy of the moving magnet is converted into electricity because a moving magnetic field entering a conductor induces current to flow in the conductor. An experiment by a scientist named Michael Faraday showed that a change in the magnetic field produces an electromotive force and current in a nearby circuit. When a conductor moves across the lines of force of a magnetic field, electrons in the conductor tend to flow in the opposite direction. This phenomenon, called electromagnetic induction, sähkömagneettien induktio, is the principle of electrical power generation. An elementary single-phase AC generator consists of magnets and a spinning coil, kaami, that is wrapped with wire. As the motor spins the coil, electrons in the wire respond to the magnets, creating a current. As the wire spins, electrons flow first in one direction and then in the other. Sine waves or sinusoidal waves are periodic waveforms whose shape can be plotted using functions from trigonometry. The sinusoidal waveform of alternating current is created by rotating a coil within a magnetic field. The positive half period of the wave corresponds with positive direction of the current and vice versa. Alternating current is also used in the transmission of electric current. The electrical grid, sähköverkko, distributes centrally generated electricity throughout the country to homes and businesses. Transportation and communication systems, factories, all modern equipment and digital devices are strongly dependent on electricity. Very high voltages are used for long-distance transmission. This reduces the losses produced by heavy current. An electrical substation decreases the voltage of incoming electricity to local lower voltage distribution. Homes in Finland are wired with 230 volt alternating current circuits. The frequency of alternating current is 50 Hz. That means the current changes 50 times per second back and forth, and the voltage passes through zero to its maximum absolute value 100 times per second. The opposition to current flow in electrical circuits is called resistance, resistanssi. The resistance of an object depends in large part on the material it is made of. It also depends on the size and shape of an object. The SI unit of resistance is ohm. 1 ohm is the equivalent of a volt per ampere. With constant voltage, current flow is increased by decreasing resistance. Decreased current results from more resistance. By increasing or decreasing the amount of resistance in a circuit, the amount of current flow can be changed. When describing the basic concept of electricity, a common analogy is a water tank. The total electric charge would be analogous to the amount of water in the tank. Voltage is akin to the pressure of water. Electric current is equivalent to the volumetric quantity of flowing water over time. Resistance is similar to pipe diameter, where a high resistance means a very narrow pipe. Electric cables are made from a central wire, which carries the electricity, wrapped in a plastic insulator to keep people from getting electric shocks. Insulators eristed are materials like plastic, porcelain, and glass. In these types of materials, the atom's electrons have very little freedom to move around. Electricity flows through them very poorly or not at all. Copper is the most popular material used for fires because it's a fantastic electrical conductor, sähkönjohde. Copper is said to have atoms connected together by metallic bonding. The outermost shell of a copper atom has one electron, which is loosely held to the atom. The copper atoms are so densely packed, so closely together, that electrons can easily move from one atom to another. In any metallic conductor, the outer electrons continually move in random manner from one atom to another. The resistivity of all metallic conductors increases with temperature, as the atoms in the metal vibrate more violently, which causes some extra resistance in the part of a free electron. Our bodies conduct electricity. Our cells use charged elements called ions to generate electricity. Some of the thoughts you are currently having can be traced to the migration of ions through membranes in the enormously complex electrical circuits of your brain. Electricity is one of the most important blessings that science has given to us. It is not possible to think of a world without it. I hope this lesson has given you a clearer understanding of electricity. Thanks for your attention. Goodbye.